Hello. In this video, I will be introducing you to the MSPM0 clock module. I will introduce you to features and how to get started with materials related to developing on the clock module. First, we are going to look at the MSPM0-based L family to learn about the features of the clock module based on the MSPM0s. The M0L family has the most basic clock tree, so we will build from here. The MSPM0L has a clock up to 32 MHz in speed, up to 64 kilobytes in flash, and rich analog peripherals. From the block diagram, we can see that the cost-effective M0L series has no support for external clock sources. It only has internal clock sources available. Let's take a look at the three main parts of the clock module of the M0L. As you can see in the block diagram, the overall structure is less complex due to the lack of external clock sources. As for internal clock sources, there are two. LF-OSC, a 32 kHz low-frequency oscillator, and SIS-OSC, a high-frequency 4 to 32 MHz clock source. Since the max operating frequency of this series is only up to 32 MHz, there is no PLL module in the clock module. Although external crystals are not supported on the M0L series, SIS-OSC is an outstanding internal high-precision oscillator, sufficient for most applications. SIS-OSC achieves an error of plus or minus 1% over the full temperature range with an external correction resistor, or plus or minus 2.5% in the full temperature range without any external components. LF-OSC and SIS-OSC source a variety of different clocks listed in the table and shown in the block diagram. The clocks that connect to the peripherals are in two different power domains. CPU clock, M-clock, ULP clock, and SIS-OSC direct output frequencies are somewhat configurable and depend on the power modes of the MCU. MF clock and LF clock are fixed frequency clocks. For more information on low power states, please watch the MSPM0 Low Power Modes video. After looking at the clock modules in the M0L, let's take a closer look at the slightly more complex clock modules of the M0G. The M0G supports up to 80 MHz clock speed, up to 128 KB of flash, and rich digital analog peripherals. Overall, the higher the performance, the more peripheral-rich the MCU, the more often the clock module has higher requirements. As a result, the M0G is equipped with an internal and external high and low speed clock sources, while the system clock can be multiplied to 80 MHz via a phase lock loop to handle high performance applications. While the clock modules of the other M0 families might differ slightly from the two subfamilies shown in this video, the overall clock structure will either be clipped or enhanced based on the clock modules of the products. Next, let's take a closer look at the composition of the clock module, the M0G. It's divided into four main sources. The first is the internal LF-OSC with a clock of 32 kHz, providing a low-speed clock signal to the system in low power modes and maintaining basic peripheral functions. SIS-OSC is still an outstanding internal high-speed oscillator providing 4 to 32 MHz. It is used to provide high-speed signal to the system, while multipliers via PLL can be used to achieve the full speed of operation of the M0G 80 MHz. Unlike the M0L, the M0G supports external crystals for both high and low frequency, named HFXT and LFXT respectively, and can be used instead of the internal oscillators. In addition to the analog input, the input of a digital clock signal is also supported. Similar to M0L, there are still several different clocks that can be configured to run from these additional sources. There are additional clock muxes as well as additional dividers on some of the clock buses. The flexibility is extremely high. This is designed primarily to meet the different clock frequency requirements of different peripherals, as well as to achieve the switching and stripping of clock frequencies in different power modes. In addition, it is important to note that the low-speed peripherals and PD0 still have a maximum input clock frequency of only 40 MHz. After looking at the features of the clock module in the MSPM0, let's look at how to quickly evaluate the clock module. First of all, it is highly recommended that you purchase a LaunchPad for the MSPM0 for easiest evaluation. Next, using the Clock Module Training Academy, it will walk you step by step on how to configure the clock module using the MSPM0 LaunchPad. Of course, we can also refer directly to the software examples in the MSPM0 SDK. If you want to customize the configuration of the clock module in any of the provided software examples, it is recommended that you use sysconfig graphical configuration to do so. In sysconfig, opening the section shown in the screen capture, you can quickly adjust the clock frequencies and parameters and then compile to generate updated code. Sysconfig greatly reduces evaluation and development time. This concludes the MSPM0 clock introduction. For viewers who want to learn more, check out the Quick Start Guides links on the bottom left. Thank you for watching this video. Please check out these additional resources about MSPM0. Thanks.